Adding movement and creative effects to your music has just gotten easier with Transit 2. If you're unfamiliar with Transit 1, the entire idea is that you have a part and you want to go to another part. You can leave it like that, or you can try and add some effects. So you slap down Transit 2, pick some effects, maybe a preset, and then just move the macro knob. Now your part's more interesting, you can experiment with large chains of effects very quickly, and it's just that simple. It's supposed to streamline, trying to add this extra level of interest. Transit 2 has three places where it shines. The first one is in static effects, the second one is in creative movement, and the third one is in transitions. Transit 2 features 28 effects, while Transit 1 had 18, so that is 10 new effects added to the collection. Here are some demos of some of the new effects in action. When you dance, don't dance another's 8-bit jam. Possibly my favorite use of Transit is to simply use it to add creative movement to a part, especially if a part repeats more than once in a track. Maybe it appears at the intro and it appears again somewhere at the outro, to just change it up a little bit. In this case, you can just pull out Transit 2, slap it down, find an interesting preset or create your own, and then just automate it in to taste. Transit 2 was of course made with transitions in mind, and it's pretty straightforward. You set up a signal chain and you take that big macro knob from 0 to 100, and then boom, you've got yourself a transition. So that's Transit 2. It looks very sleek, especially when compared with Transit 1. And there's a ton more here that we didn't talk about or show. So I would encourage you heavily, go try out a demo on your music and see how you like it. And let us know down below what your thoughts are on it. Subscribe and hit that bell icon for future videos, and have a blessed day.